tip it up.
You'll tip it up? Okay.
And windy enough, we have, five songs.
Congratulations on all your good work.
My name is Wendy Donwin. I'm from the Red Lake Indian Reservation. I came down here last night from Minneapolis. Had a cool ride. My friend's windows broke, so it was kind of a cool ride down here. But I'm going to play a song here. I hope I can do it. I just had a quadruple bypass surgery on the 12th of last month. Still kind of healing up from that. This is the first time I'm picking up my flute since it happened. So we got this elder here. He's going to pray and bless this area here. But I put out some tobacco, ask the spirits to help. So this song here is dedicated to all the grandmas. It's a healing song. We got to heal from diabetes and cancer and all things that are affecting our families. So that's all I do is play healing songs on my flute now. I'm not like John, he plays love songs. Get all the women after. That's why I had to quit composing love songs. This one here is grandma's song.
Thank you. flip it on and off.
One, two. Okay, it's working.
But he's from Mishibashi underwater panther clan. I'm from the bear clan. I have my bear clan shirt on. And so today we're erecting this statue as a beacon of friendship, of hope, of prosperity, and of sharing. Today, proclaim Northern Minnesota as a place of friendship, a place of business for all nations. White Earth Nation, Red Lake Nation, Leech Lake Nation, and Bemidji Gamog. We're all friends. This is what he represents. He's the beacon of our hope, the beacon of our friendship. And you go forth today, let all those that are here proclaim this day as a day of reconciliation. May you have good families, strong neighbors, neighbors that share with all the wealth, with all the water. A long time ago we called ZB, the river, ZB McKinnon. That was our river, that was our road, that was our highway too. So when I say DB Mekana, you know that's a roadway. A roadway for all of us to travel a long time ago. And he traveled all the way up from Leech Lake, the shores of Bemidji, and dwelled here, and dwelled among you. He was highly thought of, he highly revered, because he was a good man, he was a friendly neighbor, and he was a hard-working partner. So we could do this too, today. Let all of us proclaim a beacon of friendship, of hope, of austerity on this day. Miigwech!
I've been told by my friends that there, in Ojibwe, there's no word for a final goodbye. So the phrase, I will see you again another day. So this farewell song is only until we see each other again.
Thank you. forward! Forward!
Go on into with the program
and give a personal thank you to John Romer, Wendy Downwin, Wendy who actually taught John and John taught me, for their mesmerizing flute renditions this morning, this afternoon, and also another shaymigwetch to Larry Aiken for offering the pipe ceremony, and for all of you for being here. This is a day to celebrate. It's been a long time coming, and it's happening, and it's here, and it's good! Woo!
So, my teammate and I, Jody Bolio, and I'm Carolyn Jacobs, we so welcome you all here today to celebrate with us. This day has been on so many of our minds, the committee, and I know so many of your minds. All of you who are here today, who have supported this project through the years, chi-migwich to everybody who is here today to celebrate with us. This is a day that we are just so blessed about. Our program, as you have the copy of with you, is, see, I'm starting to get nervous. That's okay. It's honoring and healing through art and truth. Two major concepts about honoring Shaynowishkung, the Anishinaabe people, and all the people in our communities together. We are all here together, and this is the way it is. This is a very good way. And healing through truth. And you all have copies in your program of the content of the plaques that are behind Jody and me. And we know that this is such an important truth to share with you, with everybody, with our families, from whatever background we come from. So we are here today for honoring and healing, and just so happy to have you all here. We have learned so much. Our committee has learned so much along the 6 years that have gone by, you know. I don't know if I want to say quickly or slowly. They have happened. The time has happened, and we needed all this time for this to happen for us. And I just want to share just a brief bit that the thing about our committee, which was a group of Native and non-Native people coming together with our common goal, and it was so important for us that we be honest with each other, we be courageous with each other, we respect each other, because the conversations that we had around the table so many, many, many times required us to be forthright. I don't know how many times I started a sentence to Jody. I hope this isn't really stupid for me to ask, or I really don't know how to ask this or say this, but, and these are the, we all dealt with each other in the best manner possible to allow us all to grow as the time went on. I thank all the committee members really from the bottom of my heart, and I would like to recognize the committee members whose names are in the program and just ask you, please, if you will stand for your recognition. And there's a lot of people standing, so wave if you're on the committee. Yeah. Oh, I guess next was unveiling the statue. How about that? Talk about another lesson I learned. Things happen, you know?